for most martial artists that they had the ability to learn many different styles and systems from many instructors, and by so doing they accumulate a lot of knowledge. I think for Bruce Lee, he more or less a self-taught martial artist, and he had the ability to develop a system, a fighting system that uniquely of his own. He dared to challenge the old system, and he think that the traditional and classical way of training martial art is not the way to go. By so doing, he more or less modernized today's martial art by using modern scientific approach and through constant research, and to develop a system, a fighting system that he called Jeet Kune Do. I think he had adapted a set of concept and principle in his own martial art that many of us today are trying to follow. Did he continue to train while still making his movie? Yes, very much so. And training is his basic routine. And even when he is injured, and he was constantly thinking about it. Okay, training does have to be physical sometimes, and he have to visualize, and he reads a lot and incorporate a lot of philosophy into it. So yes, definitely physically, mentally, constantly training to prepare himself. And
what kind of training did he do while he was making movies?
He would look into he would look into different techniques. He would incorporate into the movie, make it more exciting, and also incorporate different techniques or make some necessary changing to improve his own martial arts skill. Mm-hmm. As a private person, I think Bruce Lee is the preferred in a quiet environment. You know, he's much of a family man, and he doesn't like to, you know, going out and partying, things like that. And I think the family come first, but in the movie, I think he really, that's what he wanted to do, and through movie, to express his martial art, and he had to commercialize his martial art, but in through movie, people will learn who he was, and what kind of martial art and how good it is. And so in the movie, he really wanted to express his feeling, and express his talent of his martial art through movie. And I think he really prepared for it. And the difference is not all much there, but except in the movie, he sort of do it in a theatrical purpose, okay? He would add more talent into it, make it more flashy, and make it more excitement, okay? So some of the technique he would use in the movie, but definitely were not using in the real fighting, okay? I think in the real, his own martial art, his technique would be more compact and more simple and direct, and everything to the point, okay? I think the movie, the third movie he made, I think Return of the Dragon with Chuck Norris, I think that movie very much represent what he would do privately, you know, as your own real fighting. Mm-hmm. A person like Bruce Lee come along once in every so many years, and he just has ability to express himself and it's such a magnetism that you know captivate the audience. I think what he's doing in the movie become a standard way of doing, you know, try to match him. I don't know, really don't know. Okay. Another person come along and try to, you know, try to match him. And I think his the way he moved, you know, the way he executed technique, and it was so quick, and people now try to imitate him, copy him. But I don't think still they can do that, and And I watched some movie recently, and they are very good. But somehow it doesn't have that kind of charisma to match him. His speed, okay. Now, I know some of the movie, they speed up, you know, a lot of movie, they speed it up to make it look good. But then you can see. But I don't know if Bruce Lee, he need to speed it up, because he's just so quick. And what make him stand out probably is the speed and the power that you know, go with it. As I mentioned before, and he constantly through scientific research into how to get speed out of the technique. I have learned a lot from him just through how to generate speed alone. And I think I shouldn't say he invented, but he gathered enough information how to improve speed. And if any instructor can teach speed, I think he's the one that can really improve your speed. He was giving a birthday party to one of his students, Daniel Santo, and as we start to sing the birthday song and cut the cake, and Bruce Lee volunteered to put out the candle. And normally he would, you know, throw a punch and blow the flame. And this time he tried to do a hook kick. And you know, I know he did it many times. If the hook kick just go and you know, and blow the candle. And as he tried to escape a hook kick, and his shoe came off his foot and just flew across the room and hit the wall. And I thought that's kind of funny. Have I ever went to the set when they do filming? Yes, I went to one of his set. He was filming the Marlo, the detective story with
James Garner.
Yes.
And anything happen?
No, not much happened. I was there the whole day just to film one sequence, the one that he had a fight with James Garner in top of the building, and he sort of executed a fine jump kick, and then he went over the building and went down below.
And the pad,
and in fact he was training with that, you know, one technique for a few days before with me, so actually he did it three times, okay, went over three times. And finally they took the third try, and actually the third try is not the best try he made. But happened that, you know, Jim Garner, they have to be coordinated with his jumping, and but they take the third one.
Did he use a spring?
They use a little miniature trampoline and just jump on it and then flew over. And they have a big, thick mat on the other side.
Physical conditioning, he always emphasized on it. And he said, if you're not in shape, you're no business, you know, in martial art.
Yeah.
And even though his business has full schedule every day, but he always keep up with his.
So what did he do? I mean, did he get up and run?
Run, do a lot of sit-up, and
lift weight,
and yeah. In fact, in 72, went to Hong Kong, Pepe and I, and when he went to Hong Kong, he did not take along with him any training equipment at all. So in 72, end of 72, December, we went there, and he calls, you know, when you come, make sure you bring some of my training equipment. So what we did, we did not carry any luggage at all, no clothing. Okay, and all the luggage we carry is a full of gloves and punch of meat, and he got a big heavy kicking seal. Okay, that thing weighed about 20-30 pounds, and we put a strap on it. I don't know if you see that the homemade movie.
No.
Which one?
It's a homemade movie. I think George Tang got a copy.
Oh no, I haven't seen it.
Yeah, in the backyard training. And we took that along. You just carry all kind of equipment.
Did he hit him. The bag a lot when he's in Hong Kong making movies?
Yeah, Herb started building a rack for the bag and for the multiple gym.
Did he, when he hit the bag, did he
Did he go rounds or did he just?
He would go around and somebody go 3 minutes, somebody go even more than that. He will not train like a boxer. Okay, he set up his own way to do it. Don't worry about punching the bag. He rely on a heavy bag a lot for the training.
Mm-hmm.
And he kicking it, punching it. And one way to develop power and also to sharpen his reflex and for conditioning also. Yeah, this to demonstrate the speed of the finger jab. And I intend to finger jab him and just flexion from his eye and pull back. And he tried to clap the hand to catch my hand, to catch my fist. Okay? But the objective for me is to coming back without being touched, my hand being touched. Okay? It's sort of like to demonstrate how quick the finger jab can be. Okay? Okay? Okay, now if you can touch me, move a little more here. Okay. One more time. Okay, more like a close range comeback. It's a trapping, okay? Once you get in the close range here, let's say you grow a finger jab and he block, okay? And you draw the hand down here and punch right here. Now in case he block me right here, okay, I trap him again by putting him down here and hit. Okay, now do it fast. Okay, boom, okay. Here. Okay. Another technique is I finger jab him, he block me. Okay, I disengage the hand here and hit him right here. Okay, one more time. Boom, okay. Now in case he block me again, okay. Block me again, I trap again, okay, boom. Do it fast. Okay.